Disabilities of honorable members, the chairman, president of the Republic of Uganda. You're most welcome, Your Excellency.
The rates of growth of 6.1% or 6.3% for the GDP of Uganda annually, like the ones Mzee Kasaja was reading, is in spite of all these bottlenecks and without factoring our oil and gas. So when you talk of 6.1, 6.3, this is just when we are asleep like now. In spite of being asleep, we grow at 6.1%, 6.3%. But if we really wake up and solve the bottlenecks, and then we add on the oil, for me, I don't talk of vision. You have never heard me talking about it. I have never talked about it. I have never said Vision 2040 because I didn't think that we need to wait for 2040. No. I think we can move faster. Now that the bottlenecks are being solved and we shall soon start using our oil, Uganda's transformation will be rapid thanks to our already educated population. Because that's what is very crucial. These educated people can be changed overnight from no job to yes. That is why the NRM, after careful study in the 10 points program, went for a mixed economy, private sector led economy with public enterprises in a few cases. If we agree that the main agent of growth will be the private sector, the next question then is, what does the private sector need to transform and grow the economy and the society? That now brings me to the issue of the 10 strategic bottlenecks. Therefore, the NRM cadres need to understand the following points. Number one, the role of science and technology as the primer of all socio-economic changes. Number two, understand the correctness of the four NRM ideological principles. And number three, understand the 10 strategic bottlenecks that have hindered our growth and transformation. All the documents are attached. I thank you. But make the correction because sometimes it brings some confusion.
Thank you very much, Your Excellency, for that very, very powerful paper.